Okay, don't laugh.
Don't move.
Don't laugh.
This is how it ends. Okay.
Just climb on real carefully.
If somebody was in the car that you had, you know, like the, like a friend or something, and all of a sudden you come across the CD, you're like,
You're here. You did it, right? You're almost going to do it right now, but here we are. So, welcome, everybody. Very special day today. And just so you know, if you don't know, Caitlin and Joseph actually chose all the words that I speak here today. So this is truly how they feel about marriage and the reason that they stand here, ready to make this important commitment. Joseph and Caitlin want to give special thanks to their parents, not only for being here today, but for being there so many times in the past. They learned how to love because they were raised in loving homes. Clint and Lara Davis and Joe and Candy McAndrew have shown by example what a happy marriage can be. They were both married on November 26th, even though years apart. And although they are creating a new home, they'll always feel the love of their childhood homes. As they come before us to be married, they wish to acknowledge the love and support their parents have given them. This moment marks a major change in their lives, but the ties of love and family with their parents will continue. Today is a very special day for Joseph and Caitlin, and it's made even more special because you, the people that they love, are here to share it with them. So this afternoon, as you witness their vows, I would ask you to join me in giving them the blessings of your love and so doing, help to strengthen this union. May you have the patience to listen, the capacity to understand, the compassion to give comfort, and the joy to laugh. We ask this day be a true celebration, not only for them, but for all of us. Allow us to be inspired by the example of their love, enlarged by their joy, and delighted by the happiness that they've brought into our midst. We give thanks for this beautiful day, for this very special occasion, and for the love which is the bond that binds Joseph and Caitlin to each other and to all of us. I'd like to read a reading written by Roycroft. I love you not only for who you are, but for who I am when I am with you. I love you not only for what you've made of yourself, but for who I am becoming with you. I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all the frivolous and weak things that you cannot help seeing there, and drawing out into the light all the beautiful and radiant things that no one else has looked quite far enough to find. I love you for ignoring the possibilities of the fool in me and for laying firm hold the possibilities of the good in me. I love you for closing your eyes to the discord in me and adding the music in me by worshipful listening. I love you because you're helping me to make of the lumber of my life not a tavern, but a temple, and of the works of my days not a reproach, but a song. I love you because you've done more than any creed could have done to make me happy. You've done it without a touch, without a word, without a sign. You've done it by being yourself. After all, perhaps this is what being a friend means. Love is the most mysterious of all forces, and its ways are strange and beautiful to behold. Just why two people who were once strangers to each other are now brought together to become one in the most intimate and unique relationship known to the world, we do not know. But we do know that this power of love is moved in your minds and your hearts, and it's a fire that can never be extinguished. There's nothing that I nor anyone else can do to make you more merry than you already are, for you're already one in spirit, and we're here today to bless your life together. To make your marriage work will take love. Love should be the core of your marriage. Love is the reason that you're here today. But it will also take trust to know in your hearts you want the best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and to grow together, even when that's not always easy to do. It will take faith to always be willing to go forward to tomorrow, never really knowing what tomorrow might bring. And it will take commitment to hold true to the journey that you both now pledge to share together. And Joseph, I'm going to ask if you'd repeat after me your vows to Caitlin, right? From this day on, I choose you above all others.
I choose you above all others.
To be my wife.
To live with you.
And laugh with you. To stand by your side. To sleep in your arms. To be joy for your heart. And food for your soul. To always bring out the best in you. To laugh with you in good times. To support you in bad. To solace you when you're downhearted. To mirror you with my soul. To share all of my riches and honor. To play with you as much as I can. As we grow old. Still loving each other. Sweetly and gladly. All the rest of our days. Okay, Caitlin, if you would tell Joseph. Did I do these backwards?
I don't know.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Okay. It's good. So repeat after me. I come here today. To join my life to yours. Before this company. In their presence.
In their presence.
I pledge to be true to you.
To respect you.
To grow with you.
Through the years.
Time may pass.
Fortune may smile.
Trials may come. No matter what we encounter together. I vow here. That this love will be my only love. I will make my home. In your heart. From this day forward. Now you've exchanged solemn vows and made a sacred promise to one another, to love, honor, to cherish, and to share the years ahead. You're joined together, but you're still individuals. Stay very close, but allow each other room to breathe. You made a commitment for the long road, and now you must learn to be good traveling companions. Walk with dignity, stand shoulder to shoulder, and take good strength from your togetherness. Walk hand in hand and take pride in your closeness. Be open and honest, but respect each other's privacy. Be caring and attentive, but respect each other's space. And never forget that you belong together, just as the waves belong on the ocean and the stars belong in the sky. Wedding rings. That will be a story you will tell your children.
Forever.
And you will tell your grandchildren, right? So.
But
look at what you already have right there. All right. Wedding rings are made precious by our wearing them. Your rings say that even in your uniqueness, you've chosen to live together as one. Let these rings be a sign that love has substance as well as soul, a present as well as a past, and that despite its occasional sorrows, love is a circle of happiness, wonder, and delight. May these rings remind you always of the infinite love you share and the vows you've taken here today. And Kate, I'll see, Joseph, if you would take Caitlin's ring. And repeat after me as you put that on her left ring finger. With this ring.
With this ring.
I marry you.
I marry you.
You are the love of my life.
You are the love of my life.
And you're my very best friend.
And you're my very best friend.
Caitlin, repeat after me as you put that on Joseph's left ring finger. Okay. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with it.
And with it.
I give to thee.
I give to thee.
All the treasures.
All the treasures.
Of my mind.
Of my mind.
And my heart.
And my heart.
By virtue of authority vested in me and in conformity with the laws of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I now pronounce you, Joseph, and you, Caitlin, husband and wife, you may kiss. So, Joseph and Caitlin have asked for a blessing on their marriage, and that would be the Corinthians 13:4. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I have nothing. If I give away all of my possessions, and if I hand over my body to be burned for a noble cause, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For now we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the perfect comes, the imperfect will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. And when I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part. Then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love of these abide. And the greatest of these is love. And I'm going to get you your flowers here. And if you'll turn and face your guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce you for the very first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Agantu.
Yeah. Mom, song.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things.
I can never be lonely if you put your hand in mine. I can never be lonely if you walk with me this time. I can never be lonely if you promise you won't leave. I'll never be lonely. Lonely. I've waited for so long, but what if it goes wrong? Never thought I'd be speaking words like these, but they're here.